for this.
What in God's name is going on in here? What was that ruckus?
What ruckus?
I was just in my office and I heard a ruckus.
Could you describe the ruckus, sir?
Turn the fucking beat up!
What is that? What is that? What is that noise?
What noise?
Really, sir, there wasn't any noise.
The Alpine's bumping, but I need the volume higher.
Bring the motherfucking ruckus! Bring the motherfucking ruckus!
Turn me on till I turn them on, let's get it on.
Stop banging on the damn furnace! You hear me now? This is the last time!
Musical sound, bring in the ruckus, you motherfuckers be giving me pants.
And still we must bring the ruckus to all you motherfuckers.
Something else. Shit. What up, though? It's another episode of the Skeeters. My name is Low Groves. I have no nicknames. It is Neezy. What's up, Neezy?
Shut up, fool. Aren't you Papa Skeet?
I don't know. Am I? Like, is it safe to use code names in here? Don't be telling nobody I'm here. Dang. Updates popping up in a nigga eardrum and shit. You hear how loud that was? Did-a-dum.
No, I can't hear.
You don't like wearing headphones?
Nah, I don't.
What, you hard of hearing or something? Anyway, what up, though, y'all?
What up?
It's been a long week. So y'all know I got the new job, but I've been working virtually, so I had to commute today. Like, cause it's like now they starting to ease us back into going to the office. So I'm back in that traffic. And man, I don't have the stomach for it no more.
Been sitting there for 2 hours?
Man.
Legs cramping and everything?
Oh no, I have, look, that's how you know I'm old. I have my little,
Oh no, you didn't. You wore that to work?
Yes. I got bad circulation in my...
Who wore your leg brace?
Hey.
You really sound like somebody old.
Nah, man. But you know when I'm sitting in traffic pumping that pedal, this way it'd be tight. It'd be weak. So I wear it all day.
Okay, old man.
Got my cup of fit.
Next, you got your hip brace that you're going to be wearing too?
No, that's you. Waddles. I got my copper fit. Jerry Rice, Brett Favre, yeah, copper fit. Mm-hmm. No, but we do got bigger fish to fry though. But first, pregnancy update. How you feeling?
Okay, so now we're starting to go back to like it's the first trimester almost. There's certain things now I can't eat. She used to like them. Now she don't no more. And if I try to eat it, it just comes back up.
She eat like her father. But what I've noticed is with the food and the drinks like that you've been selecting, like you like cranberry juice. You normally don't drink cranberry juice at all.
Yeah, now I'm drinking cranberry juice and eating waffles.
Waffles. You hated waffles before. I love waffles.
I love some good waffles now.
The baby loves waffles. Checkers. You know what I'm saying? The baby loves checkers. We know that's my baby. That's my baby.
Well, yeah, it couldn't be nobody else's.
Right.
Nigga.
I'm not talking about like that, fool. Anyway.
But, yeah, clearly we see that she's going to be like your twin.
Yeah.
So, it's fun, though. I'm excited.
Pretty much.
But other than that, you know, we're starting to get the little pregnancy swells.
Mm-hmm.
Feet starting to swell. Face is getting a little chunky. We have been doing our yoga more. That really has been helping with my hips.
Yeah, thanks to me. I told y'all, like, babe, we got to do baby yoga.
But that's been helping with my hip and back pain, so I really like that.
What about your superpower? We was talking about it on the video that we did this week.
I hear everything.
You got super hearing, you got super smell, your peripheral vision extends, like, to the back of your eyes now. You got eyes in the back of your head. I was about to say you got head in the back of your eyes.
Yes, I mean, I can hear, I see everything, you know. I know what y'all doing at all times.
That's true.
Y'all can't be sneaky no more.
I pulled a shirt like out of the closet that had been balled up, and I was like, "Babe, can you do the musty test? Like, babe, can you smell? I can smell it from in here. It's fine. I can't smell it.
I could, cause literally, you know, then when
it
you pull out something that stank, I can smell that.
She was like, "It smells fresh from here. Now go on ahead, put it on.
Yeah.
So where you want to go? Because we got a couple things to talk about. Do you want to talk about this mask stuff first? Like with Texas?
Yeah, let's go and talk about that shit, man.
All right. So for those of y'all that's listening, man, Greg Abbott, the governor who don't really give a fuck about nobody in the state of Texas, that can you put your lips to the mic? He don't care about Texas. He said he do, but he don't. And he said basically that they are gonna, he's gonna like lift the restrictions. He wanna reopen fully, and that, you know, you don't have to wear a mask at all anymore. Now, it sent everybody into a frenzy because everybody like, oh snap, we reopening. But what we're finding out is that it's a county by county decision.
Yeah.
Harris County, where Houston is located, decided that, look, whoa, until we get to like where there's little to no COVID cases at all, we're keeping our masks on. So we know what they talking about, but we're going to keep our masks on here. Now, the thing is, and I said this in the video that I made, where I read into it more on the Houston Chronicle, and they're saying that as long as you have, was it 15% of capacity, like as far as the hospital has 15% of the patients that are COVID patients for a consistent amount of days. I forgot the number of days it's supposed to be, but like it's got to be like some weeks or something, like 12 days or something like that. Then it has to be, it may not be 12 days, I can't remember. But then they would have to like, is the wave is too high, and they would have to do some other measures to like get it down again. Now the thing is, if it gets to 15%, we're already at 12%.
Exactly.
So I don't know what's going on. Well, I don't know what Abbott's smoking, bro.
And that's what I said. As soon as they do this, because the people, first thing they hear is, oh, no mask. So
yeah, I ain't gonna take my mask.
People, and you already got these crazy folks that's already out here. I don't want to wear a mask, this, this, and that. So those gonna be your first folks that's gonna go everywhere to all your stores and say, well, they said we ain't gotta wear no mask, so I'm not wearing it.
Well, when you was at your sister's
competition,
and
this lady made
like
a big fuss about putting on her mask. Security is like, ma'am, it's for the safety of the girls and everyone that's dancing and all of the people in here and yourself.
Yeah.
Just put your mask on. And they was telling her, like, as simple as that. Just put it on.
And what, she was like, nah.
No, I have my rights. And they was like, well, you don't have rights here. So either you can put the mask on or you can leave.
But why? This is what I don't get with people like that. I understand, though. Let's be clear. I understand the people that's, like, trying to buck the system and saying, fuck that, right? But
sit your ass at home.
What do you expect is going to happen? Everywhere you go, there's a sign that says mask required,
exactly.
Mask required. So you just going to be like, nah, I ain't wearing one. Do something about
they
it.
Just
and then
be
get mad
just
when
to
they
make
do
a
something.
Fuss. And it's like, shut the fuck up. Like those, because those kind of people, they piss me off. Like, I just really want to go and just punch them in their face.
I mean,
because it's like, just sit your ass. If why do you have to come out and just cause
you
such a big ass commotion for no
you
reason? For something as simple as just putting the shit on your face.
If you don't believe
or
in wearing a mask, just stay home.
Just stay your ass at home. Exactly. Yeah. If you need to go to the store that bad, you better order it online if you don't want to wear
some
a damn
people
mask.
Feel like, nah, I'm going to do whatever. It's okay. You know, we travel. Right, you ever been on the airplane where the fasten the seatbelt sign is on and you're not supposed to get up, and you got niggas that still like, man,
gets up
fuck
and go
about
to the bathroom.
Nah, they go to the bathroom, they open their thing, they stand up and stretch. I seen a nigga like do a full like, was it a peaceful warrior pose on some yoga shit in the aisleway one time. It's like, sir, can you sit your ass down?
Yeah, but that one lady, she got up and she did that shit, and we hit turbulence and she fell. And I was like,
that.
Nah.
I remember that.
That's
that
what
funny.
Your ass get.
Sit your little goofy ass. Because
you
should
have set your little ass down.
Goofy looking ass.
And see those be the people that really piss me off. So
clearly. Don't upset the baby. Calm down,
but those
killer
folks piss me off because it's like, bro, you just doing entirely too much for no reason, though. You just want to, I want to be seen. They all want to be seen as motherfuckers.
Nancy, you turned.
Because they piss me off.
Why? They ain't do nothing to you, though.
They are those people that just want to be seen because it's, why? Because main example, those same folks that don't want to wear their masks and that want to get up on the airplane, main folks, like the lady that fell. Oh, shit, if I would have set my ass down, I wouldn't have fell on this floor in front of all these people. Yeah. Oh, if I would have just put my mask on, I wouldn't have got
so
sick.
So they just want the attention just to
yes,
say they did
and it's,
something.
Don't nobody give a fuck about you.
Okay. This is, we coming off of Black History Month, but I mean, follow me, though. Could the same be said about Rosa Parks? Like, look, the rules was sit your ass in the back. And she was like, nah.
She was making
fuck
a statement, though, because it's something that was going on for Black people for centuries. So.
Right. But at the same time,
wearing your damn mask ain't got nothing to do with wearing. It's either you, do you want to get sick and die, or do you want to just cover up your face and wear the damn mask?
Some people don't believe that they're going to get sick and die.
And those be the same people that get sick and die.
What about the ones who don't?
But they do. They get sick.
But what about the ones who don't?
They get sick.
Some of them don't.
They get sick.
Some of them
something
don't
happen to them. They be like, oh, shit. I should have did this.
Nah, some, if those type of people, they be too prideful to admit it ain't the COVID.
They, oh, I just they got too the prideful to admit it, but they get sick. That you reap what you sow. They get it.
I don't think it's malicious. I think it's just it's I a think fuck you.
It is.
Not a fuck you to you, but no, like I it's know. Just a fuck you to like, fuck y'all. I'll do what I want.
Yeah, and those be the same folks that sit their ass down.
I remember I was in the airport. I don't know why all this relates to traveling, but like I was in the airport one time.
Because those be the most annoying ass folks when you travel.
I was in the airport and like, where was I? I was in Florida or Atlanta. I think I was in Atlanta. And I was walking, and the TSA agent like stop, and like you know because it was two lanes that was merging and this yeah. and that. Like they had this line go, and then you had to stop. So then the Chinese dude, behind me, dude, what the fuck? I mean, go! And I was like, the lady said, don't go. Oh. He gave me the look, and then rushed around me, and then excuse me, sir, where the hell do you think you're going? Get back in line. Oh, what? What do you mean? And I'm thinking like, bro, like. Where do you think you are exactly. that you could just get up and do whatever the fuck you want to do? This, that, and I don't know about you. I'm not going to act the ass in the airport. Because if you act the ass in the airport, you out of there, bro. You ain't never going to be able to fly again.
Because that's why I can't work at the airport. Because everybody be on a no-fly zone. Up, you fucked up. No-fly zone. You better rent a car for the rest of your damn life.
Okay, I love you. Turn this episode, bro. Normally you be all like sunshines
but
and
no, that's why I said certain jobs I can't have because I will literally, I'll be the person, oh, you done fucked up once. You lost your chance. Oh, give me, nope, no second chances.
Gotcha.
Fucked up.
All right, let's mellow this out. Turn, I don't know what's going on here tonight.
Like, that's, look, when you take your job serious, that's like when I was hall monitor, you know, you get the little roll at hall, up. Oh, you messed up. You get a ticket. Hall monitor high duties. School? Middle school and high school.
So middle school, we was the safety patrol. And
oh, I wouldn't let folks cross the street either.
Nah, fuck that. Like, we was on it, bro. We were supposed to be doing that. Like, walking people across the street, making sure, like, the younger kids isn't that. Fuck them kids, bro. We was out here. We was like the Detroit police. We was the dirty cops. We was basically running around setting up, sting operations, quote unquote, to like confiscate people's Game Boys and Pokemon cards, and then we would just keep it for ourselves. Like, so niggas would come up to us and be like, "Hey, y'all, it's a Pokemon battle going on over by the swings." We didn't have swings, but like by the slide, just in case y'all want to know. So we'd be like, "All right, bet." So we'll put our belts on underneath our jackets. And then we just kind of gather around while everybody, "Oh, Mewtwo, Charizard."
Y'all niggas in the throat.
Nigga, we was, nah, we, because I tell you another story, we fucked a nigga up one time. But, so then, you know, they doing their little cards and stuff, and then it's just, that nigga just unzip their jacket, "Safety patrol, run those cards, nigga." And then you niggas, "What, I ain't giving y'all our cards." Pack that nigga out on the playground, nigga.
We would give us your shit.
You would have get your ass away. It was like eight of us. Yeah. 12 at the most.
I would have fought till the end.
Yeah, you would have got ended.
Ain't taking my shit. You don't buy shit.
We was the safety patrol, nigga. We was the law. Anyway, speaking of the law, so in our household, things have kind of shifted. And you know, one thing about our relationship, our marriage, and our dynamic in general is that, like, you know, we kind of toggle back and forth.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm in charge, but you know what I'm saying?
That's what you say.
Nah. I'm in charge. I'll turn your microphone off right now. You want to know who's in charge, nigga? You want to know who's in charge? Say it. I'm in charge. I'll let you have it. Anyway, you brought this topic up. Nah, so you in charge, nigga. Go ahead. Lead us into the next topic then. It's your show. Go ahead.
No, you got it, player.
Nah. Gone big dog. I thought you was in charge. Gone big dog. But nah, so you know. With the pregnancy thing, I stepped up, been doing more of the cooking stuff. Of course, I'm Mr. Grocery Store Man now. So I went from, "All right, babe, I'm helping carry these groceries." Yo ass, get the eggs and the bread, and you be like, "All right, you got the rest. I'm tired. I'm going to go up these stairs." I'm going to go sit down.
And you hate it. Like, he hates walking through the grocery store. We normally do, like, our online little pickup, but... Since the ice storm,
they was like, "We're not doing pickup."
Yeah, you gotta go in store. I hate and actually fight
store.
To find
the grocery
the
store
shit.
Is the biggest waste of time possible. I love
and Lo
the fact,
hates it,
nigga. I like the grocery store. The grocery store is like a drug deal, bro. You pull up, you text, they come out, you pop your trunk, they put your groceries in. The one time they sent the little girl, I think I said this on the show.
You did.
The girl with the one arm, and I was like, "Oh shit, she need help lifting the two packs up," because we get hella water, right? lifting the two packs out the bottom, and the manager came out. No, no, sir, get back in your car. Don't help her. She's struggling. So I'm like, it's like a drug deal. Like, don't move. Just go there, pop your trunk, tap it two times. You pop it, he drop it in the trunk, you pull off. So we go from that to now I got to walk around, and we got to go in there aisle to aisle. I always tell you, make sure you got a list. You say you have a list, but we really be in there just wandering around, bro.
No, I always have a list. I have a mental
no,
list.
No, I don't need no mental. I need it on paper, I and I need have it a written mental out. List. No, you don't. Because then you'll be forgetting stuff.
If I write it out, I'm going to forget certain things.
At least four times when we've had to manually, I call it manually, when we had to manually go into the grocery store and walk around, you have forgot. Ah. I forgot to get this. Can we go stop at another store? I'm like, that's a woman thing. Y'all just like going store to store. I like to just go do what I got to do and come back.
But each store doesn't have the same thing.
Man, no.
Sometimes you got to go to different stores to find items.
If they don't have it, that's fine. But you be forgetting stuff. And if you would have had your list, you wouldn't have forgot it.
No, they just didn't have it.
Anyway.
Maybe I was looking for it and I just glanced and I was like, ugh, it's not there.
Anyway, last time. It was crowded because the other, you was like, oh, let's go. We got to go early if we want to get out the way. I was like, okay, fine.
We went at 7 in the morning.
Hold on. Let me finish. Let me finish. We did. We went at 7 in the morning, but also all the other old people was in there at 7 in the morning. And if you've been to the grocery store where only old people, not young people that's in and out with a loaf of bread and some peanut butter and jelly and that's it, or some beer and that's it, old folks with big ass carts full of like snacks for their grandkids and like Depends, like old nigga diapers, and they just moving slow. Then you got the grocery store people, which I'm like, man, can't nobody never say they ain't got no jobs, nigga, because it was like 30 niggas in the produce aisle just stocking shelves.
Yeah.
And I'm like, bro, like damn, nigga, like
they had carts everywhere.
I thought y'all supposed to do this overnight. Y'all in the way.
They were, but look, all you had to do was like, hey, can you hand me that right there? They was, yes ma'am, which do you want? Do you want the sharp cheddar or do you just want regular cheddar?
The mozzarella. No.
And so, hey. Hey, what's up, y'all? It's Neezy here. I wanted to make sure that y'all go and get your Naturally Nate Instant Moisture Duo. That's right. You know, this Instant Moisture Duo can be used on braids, locks, twists, beards, and all of your natural hair. The moisturizer is all natural ingredients. One of our key ingredients, aloe vera. You know, aloe vera is really great for your scalp. And our oil blend is a mixture of the best oils that you can use to promote hair growth and give your hair a good shine and overall just a natural glow. So you're getting two amazing products. Make sure you go to inaudibleruckus.com/naturallynay. And also you can follow us on Instagram at naturally_nay, N-A-E-E. Just whatever. Give me that right
but
there.
Anyway, we off topic. Talk about like how the spouse roles switch and all that.
Yeah, so now, I mean, you know, with me being pregnant, because standing too long is an issue right now. It starts to hurt my back, and even though we are doing some exercises, it's still a little tiresome and painful. So Lo does more cooking, and I can't bend over and like wash out the tub anymore, so now he has to do that. So he's taking on more of the cleaning roles too.
You're gonna turn me into a housewife, bro.
Hey, but you gotta be able to do it too. So, and I really do appreciate him for that. So the roles have changed. I'm more of the laid back person, just delegating rules from the other side of the room.
Nah, you like that shit. I told you, I can't wait for London to get here, so you got somebody else to tell what to do.
And he really.
I think that's gonna be reversed. I think it's gonna be, I'm gonna have two people telling me what to do, and I'm gonna be that dad that's gotta like drive around the block a couple times. Babe, are you almost home? I'll be home in 30 minutes, and the whole time I'm just up the street, just trying to gather my thoughts.
Yep, because then, Daddy, can you come and turn my lights off?
Fuck.
So, but you're going to love it. You're going to love it. But yeah, the roles have changed a lot. Do you enjoy doing that, though?
I do what I got to do, man.
Because, you know, it's just temporary.
I'll say this. There is a certain fulfillment in, like, being there for, like, the woman that I love.
Yeah, and I will tell y'all this, because sometimes I do get in my moods and it's like, oh, he's not doing it how I would do it. So I will get up and try to do it, and then he'd be like, no, sit down. Sit your ass down.
You look, because sometimes, like we said, your way ain't always the right way all the time.
Yeah, true.
And if you want, and like I told you, if you want to do it yourself. And if you don't like the way I do it, get up and do it. And if you can't, yeah, I guess you're just going to have to sit your ass down and let me do it my way then. I'm in charge, nigga, but I'm okay with that, right? Because, and I was talking with some of the homies, because there's a lot of dudes out there like that I politic with. We all having babies at the same time. Ironically, most of us is having girls and stuff, right? But being able to kind of like be there for you, like that's what I signed up for.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Now, you ask me if I enjoy it or not. I do enjoy like loving on you and taking care of you and stuff, but it's like, all right, sometimes you be getting on my nerves. And more so because it's the, like, I'm a night owl, as I've mentioned on this podcast. If y'all don't know by now, like, I've mentioned I'm a night owl damn near every episode. But I'll try to stay up a little bit later when you go to sleep so that I can at least have some, like, quiet time to myself to just, like, and then you come, babe, when are you going to bed?
Yeah, because this pregnancy has made me extra close and clingy to you. So, like, when I go to sleep, I have to, like, feel, my foot has to feel your leg there. Aww. I have to touch you. So, when you, like, because now I can go to sleep with noise. I used to have to go to sleep in complete silence.
You turning into me.
I can sleep with noise, with TV and stuff in the background. So, I just ask them. I'd be like, hey, babe, don't you want to just stretch out in the bed and watch the show in here or watch the game?
No.
You can lay across the bed and just watch the game. And then I can just go
previously,
to sleep
previously, I didn't like doing it because you would be like, turn that down. And it's like, bro, I'm not about to sit here and watch this shit on mute. Like, fuck out of here, bro.
But
like,
that's what,
like,
I said. Now.
I can't hear none of the commentary.
I can't hear
Kenny
and
Chuck.
And I can just go to sleep with the noise.
And Shaq and EJ. It's like, oh, that was
my
funny,
foot
babe.
Just
quiet.
Has to touch your leg. I just got to feel you there.
No, I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna buy you another one of them body pillows. If you got two, like, I'm gonna hide it, and then when you go to sleep, I'm gonna slide out the bed. Like, cause I, like, the other dad's been telling me how you gotta do like the little slide out so you can get away, like when your kids are sleeping stuff, when the wife and kids sleep, you just slide out the bed. I'm gonna get another body pillow.
All right, you slide out, your ass hit that flow.
Nah, I'm too smooth for the task. So I'm a put the body pillow next to it, and then just like, you gonna be like, oh babe, and then you're gonna go put your foot on there and it's gonna be warm because I'm preheated, and then you're gonna be like, okay cool, like babe is there, and then you're gonna sleep, but then you're gonna roll over because you're gonna try to touch my meat, and then you ain't gonna be able to. Know what I'm saying?
I like how you said try to touch your meat.
Well, no, our next topic was talking about affection versus sexual affection.
For me,
look, you paused like, what, nigga, you came up with the topic?
Because I thought you was going to continue to talk.
I didn't know what you wanted to talk about.
Because, like, I was reading something, right? So I was reading an article. It was online. And it was like your physical affection, not like aside from sexual, that you still need just that physical touch, and then physical and mentally. And then, but do you definitely need that sexual affection all the time, though? It's not something that's going to make or break your relationship, though.
Why you say that? That it won't make or break it? Because some people do need it.
You need it. You do need it. But you can't build your a successful relationship around having sex all the time.
Gotcha. It can't just be built just solely on sex.
Exactly. So that's like what the article was saying, because many people, they surveyed like 50 couples. Mm-hmm. And 75% of the couples was like, sex is very important. Mm-hmm. They have to have sex twice a day or every day.
Hornballs.
And it's animals, then the other people who, and they asked, how long have you been, like, for the 75%, how long have you been married? Some of these folks was either not married, they were engaged, or they've been married less than 2 years.
Gotcha. Those was the people that was fucking for like jackrabbits?
Yes.
Okay.
And now
what about the old people?
The last 25%, these are people who've been married 5+ years. Mm-hmm. One of the couples, they were married like 20, 30 years, and they were like, your first couple years, yes, because y'all just trying to get out your system. You're going to have sex all the time.
Jackrabbits.
And then they say, as your relationship gets older, as you continue to grow and mature, sex becomes more of a secondary thing. Mm-hmm. You have more so, you're doing your family time, you're having your different conversations than what you did when you were dating.
Yeah.
And it's like,
but it
we have sex tonight.
But it doesn't have to be that way, because again, there's plenty of books and movies about, oh, you gotta still spice it up, and you still
gotta
do this.
You still gotta have sex, but like they were saying, you still have to do it. But
it's more
not
effort.
It's not like, oh my goodness, I can't be with you if you're not gonna have sex with me tonight. And it's like, nah, bro.
Well, I agree with you there, because it is, like they say, it's other forms of intimacy, like other than just having sex. And at some point in the relationship, you got to be able to venture out into those instead of just the actual art of just.
Because you're not gonna have sex every day. Let's be real.
Facts.
Every couple, because at some point somebody's gonna be on their period. She got to be on her period.
Right.
And you, if you're fucking on a period, that's the issue. But that's another issue for another story. But like, you can't realistically do that every single day. There's no way to do that.
Okay.
Because you're gonna be tired too at some point. Some point you're tired, so you can't just physically or even mentally, because you can't even keep up with it. Your body can't even keep up with having sex every day, because at some point you're gonna get tired of coming. You know what I mean? You're just gonna get tired.
I don't think you can get tired of coming, man. Like, I don't know. Because, okay, and you know I love you. But, you know, when we drinking wine, and I'm, you know what I'm saying? I'm off the herbal, you know what I'm saying? We have a machine out here, man.
No, I know what you mean. Because, like, even for women, you can keep going and you can come multiple times.
You have to keep going. Just keep going.
You can come multiple times. But at some point, your body does, like, you reach your max and you just...
I don't think so. I don't believe in that.
Yes.
Nah. So, what, you think you're just tired of getting your vagina banged out? You tired of getting it relined? You're just like, you get
sore. So, you get sore after a while.
Yeah.
You do get sore.
And you keep going.
But then you get tired. Like, you've come and your body is just wore out. You're drained. You need to rehydrate.
Do you remember when we first got together?
Okay, but did we not ever have to have times to rehydrate?
I mean, you're going to rehydrate, but then you get right back into
it. But no, you stop. You go to sleep.
I'm going to sleep. On vacation. Okay, Dominican Republic.
That's different. That's vacation. I'm talking about.
Okay, now hold on. Stop. Hold on. What makes it different on vacation?
Because when you go on vacation, it's just to wild out. You don't need sleep on vacation.
Why you got to fly all the way to the other side of the country?
Because when you're at home, after a while, when you're at home, you got to live normal life. So you gonna go to sleep sometimes.
Tell her, we go deep if we don't get no sleep, because we gonna fuck all night. Nah, Dominican Republic, and this is facts. I'm not just making this up. Okay, the bed moved from the wall to the middle of the room.
That's because they didn't have it bolted.
They didn't. Hey, they should have. They should have bolted that shit.
They didn't have a bolted down bed or nothing.
Shit, that shit. Look, we ain't even know, nigga. We just in there.
Okay, but I'm saying that's different. You're on vacation. You're on vacation.
Why you gotta save the good fucking for vacation? Why
no, you can't don't. Fuck? You don't have. You can still have good sex at home. But at some point, I'm saying when you are at home, you're in your normal space.
All right.
You're going to get tired.
Nah. Okay. I see what's happening. After this baby come, we're gonna have to run it back. I'm gonna show you. It's a civilian home. You have no business involving it. I'm gonna show you.
Oh my goodness. So you don't get tired.
Yeah, I get tired.
Okay, then that's what I'm saying.
But
that's my point.
That's why I drink my go-go juice, man. You give me some red wine and some weed, nigga. I'll
go
all night.
You can go back to back 3-4 times, but then eventually
back to back had to double back and hit that ass 2 times. You're going to be tired. Let me hit it from the side just one more time.
You're just gonna be woe out and be like, I can't come no more tonight. Let me just go to sleep. And you can't do that every night back to back. You cannot.
I used to.
Okay. You old now. You can't do that back to back every night.
One and a half?
I'm saying.
Like a full pump? Like, then rest, then come back and halfway?
Nope. I'm saying full blown out every single night. You can't do that.
All right, that sounds like a challenge, though. Like, so after this baby born and we back to, like, normal stuff, man. But how long after the baby you got to wait?
Just 6 weeks.
Maybe 8,
depending on how big she is.
Got to give a nigga some of the back of that kneecap. Nigga, that's what
But, okay, if you want to put it to the challenge, you want to do the test, I'm telling you, you're going to be tired.
No, you going to be tired.
I already know I am.
Wear that ass out.
After about three a night, like, three in one
that's
night.
That's excessive because niggas got to go to work in the morning.
Three in one night. You're tired.
You may have a point.
That's all I'm saying.
What about on a Friday?
Okay, but still, at some point, even on a Friday, you're going to be passed out.
No, you are. Then that's why, like,
even any man, after a certain point, y'all do that. Do y'all little shake.
Do you remember when we first started dating? When we first started dating, that was not the case.
Okay. This is not when we're first starting dating, babe.
It could be though. It could be. We have to rekindle our love and our magic for each other. It could be. It has the potential to be. Because hey, look, dude, that 1.5 times be lit though.
You not a spring chicken no more.
A spring chicken. Look, now who's old now? Who's old now?
And most of these folks, like, that's what it's saying. And that's even my point.
You must have forgot my name, bro.
You are, when you're not that young anymore.
The big VR.
You cannot do that physically back to back every single night.
Yes, you can. When you the big VR, yes, you can.
Without Viagra.
I didn't say Viagra, nigga. I'm the big VR, the big vagina reliner. Let me hit it from the side just one more time.
Oh, my goodness. If y'all want to get in on this argument here, this debate, y'all can comment.
No. I did have another topic. All right, that's cool. So we put a button on that. Neezy thinks you can't fuck all night. Low thinks you can. If you think at a certain age that y'all still should be fucking like jackrabbits, man, y'all make sure y'all just leave a comment and go on the Facebook page, inaudibleruckus.com. Inaudible Ruckus podcast. The other thing I was going to ask, this is parenting stuff. I've been getting a lot of parenting advice from people and stuff. My question is, for those of y'all out there that got kids, the pandemic already made us like kind of be like, we kind of weary of who we hang around and this and that. How do y'all, as parents, if y'all listen to this, how do y'all deal with like the other parents of like either the kids that go to school with your kids or like the, if your kids make friends and then like they want to have a play date or something and you got to like take your kids to the park or take them to somebody's party? How do you interact with the other parents? Like, what do you do? Like, are they cool? Are they like, do you kick it with them outside of like when your kids are together, or that's just strictly, oh, we just here for the kid parties and this and that? If they're weirdos, how do you address that? Do you be like, look, London, I ain't gotta use a fake name no more. Look, London, Tabitha's mother and dad are weird, and we're not going back over there to play with them. But daddy, that's my friend. Fuck them. My daddy said I can't play with y'all no more because y'all weird.
These folks do be weird.
That's what I'm at. But I need to know, because I'm okay with telling my baby, look, I know that's your best friend, but you will get another best friend. That girl is weird, and her parents, they be killing goats in the backyard and sacrificing to the sun lord Ufuba. We can't go over there no more. Ufuba.
Yeah. I mean, you know, like, we cross that bridge when we get to it, but I just think, like, how we would handle it now, like those weird folks should be, oh hey, all right, then you get in the car,
but it's
babe,
different
because
it's your kids.
No,
it's
more
your kids though. Like, we cannot go back, but your kids like, why can't I go back over and play? They have all the toys, nigga. We got all the toys.
Y'all can come over our house. The little girl can come over our house.
Okay,
and play.
But then when the mom
you
is like,
pick them up.
No, but then when the mom is like, oh, I'm just gonna come over there and can I just sit with you while they play? And then you know how you is about entertaining motherfuckers that you don't really care for. So you gonna be sitting up there entertaining this weird like voodoo lady?
I just say no. No, you can't hang over here.
Oh, well, okay. Well, wife says no, so that's it.
I mean, that's just how I be. You can't hang over here.
I'm going to ask a question on Facebook. I need to know, though, like, how y'all deal with that. But that's all I got. Anything else you want to add, wife? Get ready, because we're about to get the fuck in.
I'm sure.
Nah, niggas about to go to sleep. Niggas been up since 5:30. So.
Exactly.
It's time to go to bed.
Tired.
Yeah.
Man, once you hit that pillow, you
out. Oh, no, that'd be you. That'd be you.
Oh, yeah, I get my rest. Yeah. I'm not going to even lie. Man.
Yo, like that last night.
even with me having to get up every 2 hours to use the bathroom, I still get to my sleep.
Yeah.
And I go right back to sleep.
And we ain't go, that's the next episode. We're gonna talk about the sleep, the weirdness of sleep, which y'all said RIP to the sleep. I ain't gonna get no more sleep after this, so I guess I'm ready
for
that. It's over.
You in for it, bro. You ain't getting no more sleep till she about 2. Maybe even
3.
That.
No, I heard 3. Yeah. There's 3.
Because soon as she get here, we both in for it then.
I guess. All right.
But make sure y'all go to Instagram and follow naturally_nay with 2 E's and get your Instant Moisture Duo. And yes, we will still have Instant Moisture Duos even after the baby comes. I'm not taking no maternity leave from my products, okay? And yeah, make sure you go to inaudiblereckets.com/shop and get your naturally name.
You can go to inaudibleruckus.com/shop. Get you the Inaudible Ruckus merch. Got some new stuff we working on. Really just been focusing on the baby and stuff right now. So y'all probably like, I know people hit me up, where's the link to buy the merch, man? Go to the registry. You know, I'm going to start putting the registry in the Skeeters, in the episode thing.
Do it.
In, like, in the RSS feed. That's what I'm going to do. Thanks. Yeah, do it. Yeah, so that, and then midnightclubmerch.com. We appreciate y'all, man. All the stuff that we have been getting for the baby, man, is dope. Because I just realized this. The crazy part about it is the baby, when they get older, they'll be able to go back and listen to these episodes and be like, damn, mom and dad was tripping.
She gonna say how crazy we are.
I know why. She don't even realize she about to co-host. When she get old enough to where she can talk and stuff, we gonna host. But all right, we're about to get up out of here. Appreciate y'all, man. Y'all mask up. Don't be out here on no goofy shit just because the governor. Don't let the governor get you fucked up out here, okay? All right, that's all I got to say about that. All right, it's an Audible Ruckus, motherfucker.
I'm on a payroll at the school. When I fed them,
I warned you about the banging of the furnace, but you wouldn't listen.